Coming up, I explain every step to swap a supercharged 3800 engine into a Pontiac Fiero, including swapping the camshaft modifications and how to properly refresh an engine. If you have any questions, ask away in the comments, and please like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. This channel all started because I decided to put together an extensive parts list and every single step required to do the swap in this thread on Pinox Fiero forum. So if you're interested in rebuilding your engine or freshening up your engine if you have a 3800 or putting one in a Fiero, this is your complete guide to doing that. If you are a 3800 fan in general and don't care about Fieros, then stick around to see build 2 and the assembly diagram part where I do my modifications. If you want to get to this thread, all you've got to do is go to Google and type in 3800SC Fiero swap, and it happens to be the second link on Fiero.nl, or you can click the link in the description. So if you guys have any questions about how to build up a 3800 motor or how to swap it into a Fiero, they should be answered in here. So I'm going to go through this forum post step by step. I would read through every part of this write up thoroughly because there could be something that you miss that's important in here. Be warned, this website does not work that good on mobile. So the first post is this welcome post here, and it just summarized the contents of this thread. Number one is how to pick out parts. Number two is the first complete parts list. Now there are two different builds in this list. One build is for a very easy, direct swap. The other one is for a more involved swap, including possibly changing the camshaft, maybe the rockers, and rebuilding parts of the engine. Then I get into assembly diagrams and torque specs, and then how to do a wiring harness if you either want to buy a harness or build a harness, and then every single instructional video on how to disassemble and reassemble the engine. And then there's some other parts while you're at it and some useful information on Fieros. So first we start in how to pick out your parts. I put together this chart and it's every single camshaft and all of the timings, and it's kind of rated by color in here. And then every single quarter mile track time that's been recorded across the internet at the time that I made this. And then every wheel horsepower dyno run next to all of the modifications chosen. So you can use this by seeing what kind of timings you might be wanting to run, what kind of times people are getting with what modifications that they state, and then what kind of horsepower they're getting with what kind of modifications they state. Next, we've got some videos of common modifications, namely one of my videos and then one of ZZP's videos. We cover differences between 3800 engines and different transmission options. Now this is the big hang up here for a lot of people. The best donor car for a 3800 supercharged engine is going to be a 98-02 Pontiac Grand Prix GTP. Later I document every part that you need if you don't get a 98-02 GTP. There's some minute differences from model to model, mostly in the wiring and the controllers. Different transmissions are mentioned here. This forum post only really covers in detail an automatic 4T65E-HD transmission. I'd say these are probably okay to around 300 horsepower, maybe up to about 400 with some modifications like changing the pump shaft. If you've got a manual car from the factory, you might want to look at a different type of transmission. It's not really worth the change a automatic Fiero to a manual unless you want to spend about $1,000. Here's some differences between the Gen 3 and the Gen 5 supercharger, and here's some previews. So let's jump down to the first build list. Build 1 cost about $1,850 at the time that I put it together. This list has a few notes at the front, what modifications I do to the engine, including a smaller supercharger pulley down to 3.4 inches, 180 degree thermostat, changing the radiator fan set points, tuning the computer, and lower range spark plugs for more knock resistance. This might pick up 30 horsepower or so. Things that you must delete off of the car, or that I assume that you delete off the car, such as the EGR, the catalytic converter, EVAP, maybe the stock intake and balance shaft. Now you will need all of these parts in this list or something equivalent to them if these aren't the best price. Every link in here should work. If you catch one that doesn't, please send me a note somehow. Here's the list itself. It starts out with air, any air intake parts that you might need, including supercharger parts. Then it moves down to fuel, or how to adapt the Fiero fuel fittings directly to the engine. Here's the fuel pump, spark plugs, exhaust. There's a picture later of the exhaust assembled. Coolant and hoses, sensors, the harness and the computer. Adapters to the transmission, maybe a flywheel if you're doing a manual car, then accessories and miscellaneous components that you're going to need. Then here's the tricky part, is mounting your engine. Now if you're not a fabricator, then you can buy engine mounts. I use Fiero Raj engine mounts. He makes some pretty good quality parts. If you want to order them, you can open up this forum post here. And then while you're at it, I would replace all your transmission mounts and engine cradle mounts and stuff too. You also are going to need a shifter bracket. I got mine from the West Coast Fiero store. I don't love that bracket, but you will need a shifter that can reverse the direction of the shifting motion on the Fiero if you are putting a 4T65 transmission. You will have to build axles, so here's all the parts needed. And then all of the parts that you will need if you do not buy a 98-02 Grand Prix GTP. So here's build two. Personally, if I had to do this again, I would not do a camshaft, and all I would do was put in some 1.9 rocker ratio rockers instead. Very easy bolt-on addition. I personally also would not go for the XPZ cam because I'm never racing this car at the drag strip. Instead, I'm putzing around town, so I would prefer to go for a lower peak power cam than the XPZ, maybe an XP cam from ZZP. So note that this build is in addition to build one, meaning that you need all of the parts from build one. This build does not touch any of the bottom end, meaning the rods, the crankshaft, the bearings, or the piston rings. And I do designate in here if one part or another is replacing something that was found in build one. So let's work through this build two list. In here I put a Series 3 or Gen 5 supercharger on the top. I picked up a supercharger from a junkyard. With that, you're going to have an adapter to get to the throttle body. I also used a Cadillac Northstar from a DeVille or a Seville throttle body. It's the same diameter, but you still need an adapter. This is a great throttle body for this, as it's a cable throttle still. It's big, and it has a properly sized mass airflow intake for a little bit higher airflow. This will require reprogramming, however. I plugged some coolant holes with some dimes and some JB Weld in the upper intake. Here's the mass airflow mentioned earlier. All new gaskets and seals. I would definitely get all GM Genuine or AC Delco seals and gaskets wherever possible, because I've ended up with some off brands that just don't fit right and don't seal. New supercharger bolts for using a Fenelec spacer, which is a 1-inch spacer. You could choose to use an intercooler instead, but I decided not to for complexity and size. A really small supercharger pulley. 2.8 inches, about the smallest that you can go without grinding down the snout of the supercharger. You can also get an overdrive balancer pulley if you want even more supercharger RPM. Freeze plug to plug the EVAP inlet on the Gen 3 supercharger, and just stuff to hook up the throttle. Now, for fuel, I decided to get some 80-pound Siemens DECA EV1 injectors. You can get them from Intense or ZZP. I would definitely go through a name brand because you might get a fake on eBay. Got a fuel pressure regulator because I built some custom fuel rails. You can also buy some nice fuel rails from Aeromotive. I'd get even colder spark plugs. I got Autolite AR103s. They replaced the spark plugs in build one. Now this entire exhaust system is brand new to this build, and I show pictures of it later, but basically it's straight pipe. Next is the cylinder heads. Series 3 cylinder heads have a 0.030 inch larger intake valve than Series 2. That's probably not going to get you much, but I did do a valve job on my cylinder heads at a machine shop. For the XPZ cam specifically, and you'll have to calculate this on any camshaft, I needed to actually take off 60 thousandths from the top of the valve guides so that it had enough clearance for the high lift camshaft valves and rockers to clear the valve guide. I got an MLS head gasket. I did replace the rocker arms with 1.65 rockers. Now, 1.6 rocker was the original 130 pound valve springs. You could probably go a little bit higher than that. Brand new seals, LS7 lifters, which are pretty forgiving as far as tolerance goes. New head studs. Do not use the ARP thread sealant. Instead, use some sort of a actual sealant. I ended up using a Permatex Ultra Black gasket maker sealant for the head studs. A thread chaser to clean out the threads. Push rod length checker, that's really important to get. Depending on your camshaft's lift, and depending on the lifters you use, and your head gasket thickness, and your rockers, you're gonna have to get different length push rods. Now, I detail in all my videos posted later how exactly to measure all these things and how to install them. So with XPZ Cam, I deleted the balance shaft and installed a double roller timing chain, which also requires deleting the timing chain tensioner. Now, if you decide not to get a new double roller timing chain, it might still be a good idea to replace the timing chain because it does wear out, along with the timing chain tensioner. You also have to machine the oil pump cover down by 0.023 inches. Be sure to do it properly with a surface grinder and don't grind down the pump side because that's nice and flat already. Instead, grind down the side that's not on the pump. You're going to need an extra thick front cover gasket for the double roller timing chain to clear. There's a lot of bolts in here that will yield, so you need to replace them. One being the camshaft bolt, another being the crankshaft bolt, and then I replaced all my seals and stuff. For my transmission, I put in a hardened input shaft, a chrome moly pump shaft, a hardened fourth clutch shaft, some new gaskets and seals. If you do take your transmission off, you will need to replace the flywheel bolt. And I got a new torque converter because the torque converter that came out of the engine was not the highest stall. So I got the highest stall torque converter that was made to bolt up to this engine, because this car is a lot lighter weight, and so you're gonna want a higher stall. Next, I did put a Positraction differential into the transmission. This is a bronze clutch style. It definitely works. It's not amazing. I might go for a Phantom Grips limited slip differential next time. Now, you can change the gearing in the 4T65s. However, the ratios are pretty close on them, and not all these chains were made for this kind of power, so I might not. I just left my stock gears in there. Coming down to the meat of this post is getting into the assembly diagrams and torque specifications. First picture here is firing order. Second is a hand drawing of coolant hose hookups. Then we get down to the supercharger hookups. Then we get down to the transmission hookup. And this is how to do your exhaust. So you're going to have to custom weld this exhaust. Now, Fiero Raj also makes this U-bend pipe you see here. And you're going to have to figure out a way to weld up the rest of this exhaust. Continuing on, everything below this point is required for build 2 if you're going to disassemble the engine, replace seals, freshen it up, and do some light modifications. This is the torque sequence required for installing the supercharger. This is the torque sequence for the lower intake manifold, for cylinder heads. And then here is every engine exploded assembly diagram and every part number on the engine. Now, you can go to this link and find what part that on this engine is. Here's more assembly diagrams. This is the front cover. Here's the camshaft. Here's how to hook up the transmission to the engine. Here's how to line up the timing on the timing gears. Here's how a PCV system works with a Northstar throttle body on a Series 3 supercharger. This is the exhaust setup that I did for build 2 that's a little bit more free-flowing. And then here's some transmission information, and here is an exploded view of all the 4T65E transmission components. You can also go to this link and you can order any component on this picture. Next is the wiring harness and computer programming and tuning. Now, there's two options here. You can buy a harness there's a couple of guys that make them. One's James Brown, the other one's Dan McElmoyle. Be sure to include this information here if you're going to send them your harness, and they will do a programming for you. Or you can come down and build a harness, and I personally would prefer to just buy it myself, but there aren't really that many connections to make. My biggest concern with the harness, besides functionality, was just the layout and how it looked. So this is a picture of the original harness that I put in by myself. All I did was splice into it, and I didn't really lay it out properly. If you want a better looking harness, this video kind of shows what James Brown's harness looks like. Now, what I would do is go to alldatadiy.com and buy the pinout of your car. And this is a pretty good diagram of how to make all the connections. There's only about 14 or so connections to make to the Fiero. You're going to have to make a speedometer conversion circuit. Here's how to do that. And here's the pinouts of every connector on the Fiero side. And then here's your OBD2 connector. This is optional. You can hook up the GTP electronic cruise control instead of use the Fiero's vacuum cruise. You're going to want to hotwire the fuel pump, bypass any circuitry between the fuel pump and the battery so that there's less voltage drop and the fuel pump gets as much power as it needs. And this is important if you're going to be running a higher than, I'd say, 255 liter per hour fuel pump. Ideally, a 340 is what you would want for E85. And then here's how to repin some connector. The next section is a list of videos in order of what you're going to want to do to remove the engine, replace the fuel pump, install a supercharger pulley, change the supercharger oil, install the oil sending unit, thermostat, water pump, install your engine brackets, make a custom fuel rail if you want, how to build axles, how to install the transmission, how to mount the transmission and install the supercharger belt, how to install the wiring harness, how to install AC hoses, all hookups on the Fiero side, hook up the exhaust and install the engine in the car, more routings and hookups, and more routings and hookups, and then more routings and hookups. Under this line is everything required for build 2. Now before getting into it, I would watch some of these GM service technique videos. Here's how to tear apart lower intake manifold, how to tear apart the entire top end of the block, rebuild the supercharger, how to install the camshaft, the front cover, the balancer pulley, timing chain, balance shaft. Another alternative, how to disassemble your cylinder heads. Another factory video for installing heads, valve train, the balance shaft, intake manifolds, and valve covers. How to deck your surfaces if you are going to remove your heads and be doing any heavier modification on them. I would probably do this regardless of how much modification that you do if you ever remove your cylinder heads. Installation of heads. This video, I don't recommend using the same method they do to check push rod length for getting new push rods, assembling custom exhaust, custom fuel rails and accessories, and titanium exhaust wrap. And down here is a step-by-step instruction for porting the cylinder heads. If you're going to take it to a machinist, I'd just drop off these instructions here for them. Here's some videos on how people like to port these heads. Now, when you're going to tear this engine all the way down, it's a good idea to inspect the bottom end, the rods and the bearings and everything. So here's a good step-by-step process to do all of that. Some videos on that. And then while you are going to be swapping the engine out on the Fiero, here's some other useful things to replace while you're doing this, because they're just a lot easier to get to or get off the car while the engine's out. And then last, here's some useful information on this video that's not necessarily related to this swap, but just for further reading. If you have any questions, I'd love to answer them in the comments below. And that's it for this video. If you liked what you see, please thumbs up, comment, subscribe, and hit that notification bell.